Jesus Christ did not speak English. You say, well, of course he didn't. We know that. What do we look like, a bunch of dummies? Of course he didn't speak English. Well, wait a minute. Do you know what that means? That means that Jesus Christ never said the word hell. Ah, true. Because hell is an English word. It's derived from the Latin, but Jesus Christ didn't speak Latin either. The New Testament is recorded in Greek. What word did Jesus Christ use here? He never said hell. Remember, he didn't speak English. You'll agree with me there. So go to your concordance. If you're using Strong's, you go to page 478. If you're using Young's, you go to page 474 and 475. And you will find that the Greek word Jesus Christ used here was Gehenna. Gehenna. He did not say hell. He said Gehenna. What in the world is Gehenna? You're wanting to know what Gehenna is. I'll tell you exactly what it is. You get your Bible dictionary out, you can find out for yourself. Gehenna was a valley. It is. It still is. It is a valley on the south and west corner of Jerusalem. It formed part of the border between Judah and Benjamin. It's a ditch. You can go there today. Jesus was talking about a ditch outside of Jerusalem. You can even get a map out today of the Holy Land and take out that map and you look at the southwest corner of Jerusalem and you will find a valley there called the Valley of Gehenna. In the Hebrew, it was called the Valley of Ben-Hinnom. That means that the sons of Hinnom owned it. Ben, that was the Hebrew word for son. And in the Greek, they called it Gehenna. It is a geographical location. Now, here's something really strange. Why did the King James translators take a word Gehenna and translate it hell? Now, every other place in the scriptures where a geographical location was noted, such as Capernaum, what did they translate it? If they saw the word Capernaum in the Greek text, they translated it Capernaum. If they saw the city of Jerusalem, they translated it Jerusalem. If they saw the city of Bethany, they translated it Bethany. Now that makes a lot of sense, doesn't it? But look what happens here. All of a sudden they come across Gehenna, which is another place, and they translate it Gehenna? No, they translate it hell. It's unaccountable. They shouldn't do that. Can I have a glass of water, please? This is hard work explaining these scriptures, you know, because you just cannot trust the translator. You've got to look at a concordance. It keeps them honest. A concordance keeps the translators honest. When you get your statement back from the bank, do you trust their figures? No, you check up on them because you're talking about your money there. Well, you should be more concerned about God's word here than you are about your money. We've got to check up on the translators. And you look in your concordance and you'll find that Jesus never said hell. He said Gehenna. And this is what it meant to his hearers. It meant a valley in Jerusalem. And I'm going to explain the significance of it in a minute. Thanks for that water. I do have to say one thing, though, before I get into that. You can go to hell today. Sure, yeah, you can go to hell today. You can go to Gehenna. I talked to a guy that went there. Yeah, he said he walked through it. He said it's real nice there, especially in the spring. You know, the birds are chirping and the grass is green. Gehenna is not now functioning as it will in the future. And that's the key here. We're going to talk about the function of Gehenna. What did his hearers think when he said Gehenna? They knew exactly what he meant, and it has nothing to do with the torture of unbelieving mankind for eternity. Nothing to do with it whatsoever.